प्रजानाम एव भूत्यर्थम सत्ताभ्यो बलिम अग्रहीत प्रजानाम एव भूत्यर्थम सत्ताभ्यो बलिम अग्रहीत सहस्र गुणम उत्सृष्टम आदत्ते ही रसम रवि सूर्य द सन collects vapor from little drops of water. He collects only from little drops of water. So does the king. They give back copiously. They collect these from the people only for their well-being. So the collection of taxes or the vapor from the water drops are only from small trickles, but they all go back to the people manifold. So the purpose of taxation and also the way in which it is done has been voiced even then. And this in Raghuvamsa refers to the Purvaja or the elders belonging to Ikshvaku dynasty, father of Ayodhyapati Rama, Dilipa, grandfather. It refers to Dilipa, the king. So in continuation of the reform measures already taken so far, the tax proposals in this budget will introduce further reforms to stimulate growth, simplify tax structure, bring ease of compliance, and reduce litigation. Personal income tax and simplification of taxation. So in the interim budget of 2019, our government exempted individuals having income up to 5 lakh of rupees from paying any income tax. Presently, an individual pays 20% on income between 5 lakh and 10 lakh and 30% on income between 10 lakh. That's the prevailing matrix. Further, currently the Income Tax Act is riddled with various exemptions and deductions which make compliance by the taxpayer and administration of Income Tax Act by the tax authorities a burdensome process. It is almost impossible for a taxpayer to comply with income tax law without taking the help from professionals. In order to provide significant relief to the individual taxpayers and to simplify the income tax law, I propose to bring a new simplified personal income tax regime wherein income tax rates will be significantly reduced for the individual taxpayers who forego certain deductions and exemptions. Under the new regime, sir, an individual shall be required to pay tax at a reduced rate of 10% for income between 5 lakhs to 7.5 lakhs against the prevailing 20%. So, anyone who's earning between 5 to 7.5 lakhs, sir, today pays 20%. We are now reducing it in the new regime, which is devoid of exemptions, to 10% only. So 20% comes down to 10%. Sir, the next example. For income between 7.5 lakhs to 10 lakhs, I earlier said about 5 to 7.5, now I'm saying about 7.5 to 10 lakhs. So for income between 7.5 lakh to 10 lakh, he or she will pay at the reduced rate of 15% only against the current prevailing 20%. Sir, similarly, for the income between 10 lakhs to 12.5 lakhs, presently the tax is 30%. For income between 10 lakh to 12.5 lakh, the present prevailing rate is 30%. That is now being brought down to 20% only. Sir, the income between, I spoke about 10 to 12.5 lakhs. Now, 12.5 lakhs to 15 lakhs will be taxed. At the moment, 12.5 to 15 lakhs is taxed at 30%. Now, those earning between 12.5 lakhs to 15 lakhs will be charged at 25% only. Sir, incomes above 15 lakhs will be continued at 30%. but no exemptions at all. Those earning up to 5 lakhs shall not pay any tax either in the old regime or in the new regime. So the proposed tax structure will provide significant relief to taxpayers and more so to those in the middle class. I just want to very clearly read out 0 to 2.5 lakhs exempt now, will be exempt in the new scheme also. 2.5 lakhs to 5 lakhs, 5% now will be 5% in the new tax rate. 5 to 7.5 lakhs, 20% now will become 10% in the new rate. 7.5 to 10 lakhs, 20% now will be 15% in the new. 10 to 12.5 lakhs, 30% now will now come to 20%. 12.5 to 15 lakhs, 30% now, 25% in the new rate. Above 15 continues at 30%. In the new tax regime, sir, substantial tax benefit will accrue to a taxpayer depending upon the exemptions and deductions claimed by him. For example, just to make it clear, for example, a person earning 15 lakh of rupees in a year and not availing any deductions whatsoever will pay 1,95,000 as compared to 2,73,000 that he is paying now in the old regime. So his tax burden shall be reduced by 78,000 rupees. That will be the reduction in the tax that he has to otherwise pay. Then this is the example of somebody who earns 15 lakhs. He would still be a gainer in the new regime, even if he was taking deduction of 1.5 lakh under various sections of Chapter 6A of the Income Tax Act under the old regime. The new tax regime, sir, shall be optional for taxpayers, so there's no compulsion. Those who want to be in the old regime can continue to be in the old regime, in the old rates, in the whole sets of exemptions and deductions. But those who wish to come into the new are welcome to come into the new. An individual who is currently availing more deductions and exemptions under the Income Tax Act may choose to avail them and continue to pay the tax in the old regime. A new personal tax income tax rates will entail estimated revenue foregone of 40,000 crores per year. We have also initiated measures to pre-fill income tax return so that an individual who opts for the new regime would need no assistance from an expert to file his return and pay income tax.